South SF Library to honor legacy of late Fil-Am leader Alice Bulos. South San Francisco, everyone who was involved in the Filipino American community has walked into this particular house on Liberty 4. Galway Avenue here. The two-story structure is indistinguishable from the rest of the tract homes parallel to Westborough Boulevard, a main artery connecting Daly City, Pacifica, San Bruno and South San Francisco, the northern municipalities of San Mateo County. These days the house is mostly quiet. Unlike the many years before, autumn 2016. Almost half a century earlier, 2,444 Liberty Fourth welcomed visitors of every background from near and far, seeking counsel from the lady of the house. By 1985, sociologist-turned-organizer Alice Pena Bulos had achieved celebrity status for espousing innumerable causes in the name of her community. In the 90s, she wielded influence like few Filipino Americans could, invoking her battle cry, empowerment, becoming the first Fil-Am appointed by a sitting U.S. president to serve on a federal post when Bill Clinton appointed her to the United States Council on Aging. Though consigned to a wheelchair for sciatica in the 2002, she continued to attract the likes of venture capitalist and former state controller and unsuccessful gubernatorial candidate Steve Wesley, who would kneel before her to receive her blessing. By the second decade of the 21st century, the acknowledged godmother of Filipino American empowerment was fading from the political circuit, if not from the consciousness of Filipinos and non-Filipinos. She has guided and endorsed appointed and elected officials, legislative aides, political and business players. She has lost mobility and her voice, but not her passion to inspire people, most of whom saw her as a mentor, confidant and model. Back to Bulos and the Filipino American community with a tribute fittingly set on the week after Mother's Day. Imagine her elation had she witnessed the election last year of the first Filipino Americans to her home city council, both of whom consistently hail her as their role model. Council Member Mark Nagales, former legislative aide to Bulos' longtime friend SSF Council Member then Assembly Member Jean Mullen before, joining the Office of U.S. Rep. Jackie Spire, constantly named Bulos in his remarks to Filipinos. City Council Member Flor Nicolas, the first Fil-Am woman elected in her town, had turned to Bulos for political advice when she decided to heed their common friend South San Francisco Mayor Carol Matsumoto's encouragement to run for office. Although she is not here with us anymore, I could almost hear her voice and see her smiling face when I found out about my winning the November election, Nicolas said. Many times she urged me to run, but I kept on telling her that it was not the right time. I had children to bring up and career to develop. At my age, I thought the time had passed and the right time to run for an elected position will never come, but it did. I want to show her my gratitude for the seeds she planted that are the fruits I now reap. Nicolas is at the forefront of Filipino American empowerment, celebrating the legacy of Alice Pena Bulos, a campaign initiating a photography drive and oral history project launched by the South San Francisco Public Library. Honoring Bulos was the brainchild of Eva Martinez, librarian slash archivist of the School History Room. Missing South San Francisco Public Library has three sites. The Grand Library on 306 Walnut Avenue off Grand Avenue is a historic Carnegie Library and registered as a historic landmark, having been built in 1916 on a 000 grant from industrialist Andrew Carnegie. It houses a treasure trove of local yearbooks, memorabilia, newspaper issues and clippings, journals, government documents, maps, phone books, pamphlets, books, oral history tapes, and magazines plus thousands of photographs. Martinez, reference librarian since 2017, was tasked to look at their history room which hasn't had anyone managing it for at least 10 years. Her eye immediately discerned that the system's historical records did not truly reflect the diversity of the town. We noticed that the stories of women, African Americans, Asians and Latinos were slim or missing, she told Inquirer.net. For Asians, in particular, we wanted to capture the stories of the Filipino community, when the community began, how it has developed over time, and the accomplishments and hardships. organizing the History Room encouraged Martinez and two library assistants to embark on a series to increase material on unrepresented communities beginning with the programs of last History Month. We also noted a problem with the stories of the women who lived here or were born during the early days of SSX, added Martinez. They were only mentioned in the context of their husbands' or fathers' accomplishments. So, we decided to delve into their stories, too. Currently there is a display at the Grand Library highlighting the lives of four amazing local women. Honoring Alice Bulos, here's two of these marks. Hilda contacted me to ask if I knew Alice, said Nicholas, a founding member of the organization. I jumped at the chance and spread the word, including contacting Alice's family and community leaders familiar with Bulos' lifetime service. Nicholas is one of the last political aspirants to benefit from Bulos' mentorship. Their relationship went all the way to 1988, when the leader spotted the newcomer at All Souls Church, also in South City. Change maker Tita Alice approached us, introduced herself and gave me a card showing that she was one of the county's commissioners left square bracket commission on status of women rights square bracket. She told us that if we need anything, simply call her, recalled Nicholas, who was somewhat intimidated by the matriarch who happened to be the grandmother of a classmate of Nicholas' daughter. Bulos invited the Nicolases to her home the very next weekend to meet fellow Filipinos engaged in the community, having heard that Nicholas and husband, Nenner, were interested in involvement. Nicholas later gave Bulos a ride to events, observing her in action, getting personal advice. I learned from her that for us to effect change, we Filipinos should participate in the political process. Otherwise, we will always be taken for granted. We need to be patient with our fellow Filipinos, said the well-known church and community volunteer. The council proved spot on with Nicholas victorious in her first campaign, as was Nagales. She is truly the grand dame of the Filipino political empowerment. She inspired many Filipinos to run for office and unite behind each other, said Nicholas, who's optimistic that Bulos' mentees will turn out for the May 18th tribute. Our main goal is to collect primary source materials through the Oral History Project so that these communities can tell their own story in their own words, Martinez said from an archivist conference in Long Beach. The May 18th event takes place 10 a.m. and 12 noon at the Mater Dolorosa Church in South San Francisco. It will feature a slideshow about the Bulos and the community followed by guest speakers who will address the work of the city's most famous Filipino American residents. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.